This guy and his band were the biggest act of the 1980s. They didn't just break America, they absolutely owned it. His songs remain timeless, and our obsession with him as a nation is reflected in the fact that he dominates the front pages of our papers. It gives me a tremendous amount of pleasure to say the following words. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Boy George! How are you?
You're very handsome in real life.
Isn't he lovely?
Thank you very much.
Looking boy.
Now this is quite a fond moment for me because you were the first ever interview that I ever did.
And you were so nervous.
I'm still nervous now.
Why? No, you're not.
Now it's been an unusual year for you. Are you happy to see the back of it?
It's been an interesting year. Bit sweeping, you know. I'm not afraid of a bit of work.
But let's talk about the music. The music that you guys created in the 80s and your fellow kind of musicians from the 80s, that music is still ever so popular. Is that a compliment that people are still into 80s music?
I think if music touches people, it's a compliment. You know, that's the point. You know, you're expressing your feelings and emotions. And if you can touch people and relate to people, that's the magic of singing, you know.
Who would be the worst person that you could duet impossible with tonight?
Why would you ask me that? Because you want me to be bitchy, right?
Yeah, of course.
My favourite person would be Bowie.
Right.
Lulu, she's here tonight.
Yeah.
And Nina Simone.
All right. Well, who are you performing with tonight and why?
My friend Amanda Coates called me to ask me to do the show. She said, you won't want to sing with this person. I said, who is it? She said, yourself. I went, and no way.
Now, we've taken a performance from the Russell Harty show.
Yeah.
The very famous interview that you did with Russell Harty. Have you got any memories of that night?
Well, it's the famous ad for a cup of tea, and it haunted me for 20 years.
You preferred a cup of tea to...?
To sex.
Right.
But you know that's not true.
Don't tell everyone! The secret's out! Now, George, let's travel back in time and take a journey through your music to 1982.
George Allen O'Dowd, or Boy George to you and me, has been making hits and hitting the headlines for almost 25 years. With his striking looks and his distinctive soulful voice, his band Culture Club dominated the charts on both sides of the Atlantic in the 80s. Boy George continues to remain a global pop icon and a successful music DJ. He's earned a unique place in the nation's hearts.
I never thought I'd say this on a family show, but it's now time for some boy-on-boy action. Singing Karma Chameleon, please welcome for our final duet impossible, Boy George and Boy George! Tonight, what a gig. It just leaves me just enough time to thank all of our acts, Westlife and Roy Orbison, but flying, the Sugar Bears of Dusty Springfield, Katie Mellow and Ava Cassidy, and finally, Boy George! Good night, and remember, nothing is impossible in life, and as it turns out, that includes singing live after your death. Have a fantastic new year, and achieve the impossible! Good night!
And more from Vernon in the new year, back with a new series of Just the Two of Us. Next tonight on BBC One, a plan is hatched. Feathers fly in Chicken Run.